recording for this class. Alhamdulillah, I want everybody to have their mask on. I'm going to be speaking, so I'm not going to have my mask on, inshallah. Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillah. We're hopeful to have another teacher who's going to replace me, who's going to teach this class for the Islamic manners and morals. I'm discussing. He didn't say yes yet, but we're very hopeful. Okay, he's going to be probably most likely would be joining us through Zoom on Fridays. Maalin kala ma taqaan laga yaabaa inuu class kan digo oo ajnabi ah. We're discussing. He did not say yes yet. Wali musan haa ma waran wali. Lakin that's what the hope is, inshallah ta'ala. And Sira, we're going to have that Sheikh Muhammad Sayyam Fala, who used to teach taught the fiqh, right? Last time, the Indian big beard. He taught the fiqh, right? Yeah, he taught the fiqh. He's going to teach the seerah. He said he's going to have a good time with the seerah, inshallah ta'ala. And he's going to be joining us today at, I think, approximately 6:05. So I think I'm going to speak about 10, 15 minutes today. And then we are going to pray. And then after that, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to begin the next class, which I think he's going to give us an introduction on seerah. But the actual classes, because we want people to sign up this weekend, actual classes, I think we're going to give you assignment on the Quran on the weekend. But the actual classes will begin next Friday, inshallah ta'ala. That's why today is registration. We want the families to join, a lot of people to join, a lot of people. We send the links, inshallah ta'ala. So to give you a little overview of Al-Akhlaq, you see on the first page of that book, it talks about the sidq, al-amana, al-afaf, al-haya, al-shaja'a, al-karam, al-wafa, husn al-jawar, musa'adatu dhawi al-hajat, hasb al-maqdara, and nazhatu an kulli maharram Allah. They talk about those 10 items in the first page of that book. Umar Khair, you have this book? You guys bought this book, right? Yeah, you need to bring, because this is very important. We are going to teach 3 subjects, so you're going to bring this book Friday and Saturday. Yeah, some of you who don't have the book now, I think you're going to have to buy, you're going to have to pay for it. So they divided this book into like 2 sections. You see how on top it says part 1 and part 2 right there? So they divided into 2 books, part 1 in one book and part 2 in another book. They mixed up a little bit because I think there is a seerah on both of them. And when I asked the gentleman who's the owner of the Sira class is not until 6, so I don't know why you give me this heads up. Okay. When I asked them, he's like, because the feedback they got from other masajid, they added Sira into both parts. So you will be, I don't know where they're going to assign. You're going to have both books if you don't have that book yet. Buga laba qaybada loo qaybiyay dadkan horo wiibsaday just one book ay haysanayaan laakiin dadka cusub asoo laba buug laga soo dhigalahay hadda moogtay marka that's what I'm just telling you. You had the book, right? You had the old book. You had this book, right?
No.
Oh, I didn't write your name, by the way. What's your name again?
Salman.
Oh, you're Salman? Oh, I'm sorry. How did I miss you? I didn't even see you, man. By the way, okay. All right, sorry, Salman. So, I'm not so join Korean, but we are expecting more people. We expect this class to be at least not the head one. There's 2 of them online, right? So, Ad, you guys are 2, right? So, Ad, yeah, actually, they're included there as well. Yes. Yes, okay. Salman Salah, right? Yeah. Okay, thank you. So we are going to, inshallah ta'ala, I'm gonna talk about a little bit why morals are important. Listen to me, guys. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I'm not gonna get into the book, but I'm just giving you a little overview because we might probably have that other teacher taking over starting next Friday. So hopefully he will. But if he hasn't, I will teach it, inshallah. And I'm just going to try to speak only in English, inshallah ta'ala. So what happened is we are teaching an entire book based on Islamic manners and morals. Dhaqanka ama dabeecada Islaamka iyo maaragtay iyo muxuu ahaa iyo qofku yani siduu ula cilaaqoonayo dadka kale. How you interact with others. And in this book, I think they're going to cover those 10 items. Truthfulness, honesty, chastity, bashfulness, courage, generosity, loyalty, maintaining good relations with neighbors, helping those who are in need according to the one's capacity, and abstinence from all the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibits, right? These are very, very important subjects that they are going to cover. You know, speaking about truthfulness and asidq, it's a huge, you could write an entire book, maybe 3 times the size of this book, speaking just on asidq, speaking just being among those who are truthful. So you have to understand, if I go back a little bit, you have to understand our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the number one reason why he was sent is to perfect the manners, to perfect the imperfections of the manners. You know, everything that you do in Islam is some way or the other a manner, right? It's an akhlaq. It's a value. It's something that has a tangible meaning to it, okay? So this is why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. I was just sent to perfect the imperfections of manners. This is what the Quran actually speaks about when he speaks about the Prophet. وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. You are in a high status in terms of manners, in terms of morals and manners, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala actually speaks about piece by piece his body. Allah talks about his sam', you know, his hearing, his eyesight, his qalb, his fu'ad, you know, his heart, his entire being as a person. مَا كَذَبَ الْفُؤَادُ مَا رَأَى. His heart did not disbelieve what he saw, right? Saw. مَا يَنْدِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى. He doesn't speak of his mind or his desires. إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَى. That actually makes a tanzih based on what the Prophet is saying. So that means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him a sanctity against falsehoods, against al-kadib, right? Allah gave him a sanctity, which is a protection, a sainthood. You know, like you see sometimes Saint John. Saint means someone who is very protected, right? And not that those Saint Johns are protected, but basically the actual protected person is Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whom Allah actually dedicates how he spoke. If Allah dedicates for you the way you speak, Allah gives you a complete freedom in the way you speak and you utter. And there are actually angels recording our acts and our worships and our sayings and our ibadat and everything. So akhlaq is very important because they say, you know, the Arabs used to say, man faqad al-akhlaq faqad al-hayata kullah. Whosoever misses out on manners, he misses out or she misses out on entire life, right? Because you have to be a principled person as a young person, young woman, or a young man, right? You have to be principled. Because like, you know, even though Allah gave every single human being what's called free will, you know what free will is? Who could tell me what free will is? Saad, could you tell me what free will is? Or those of you who are sitting right in front of me, you could tell. Huh? It's a freedom. It's a kind of freedom, but you have to be specific. What kind of freedom is it? Yeah? What kind of freedom is it, Ayan? Exactly. Thank you. And thank you for Suad. Also, she said you get to do what you are able to do, right? It's true. Even though Allah created hellfire on the left and Jannah on the right, the ability for you to choose which one you want to go based on the acts and based on the premise of what you do, That's called free will. Even though Allah show you the way, it's up to you whether or not you take it. It's up to you whether or not you pray, right? A Muslim is being commanded to pray. That's an act. That's an akhlaq. That's a character, right? That's a moral. But whether or not that Muslim or that person wants to pray according to how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants, obviously, that's what we are talking about. That's called free will. إن أدمارك تعذو مسكح هذا فكرة اختيار بعف سما عف عف سما اللي يقول هذا صار مرنين اختيار إلى يروح كسيء دورا سين أنا دورنا كدورا هذا يقان الدور ربع يقان وكني كده هي قبي there was a poet who said you have the choice and Allah chooses it for you. You got the choice. So even though Allah commanded you to pray, some people they just sleep, right? So that basically they chose the wrong way. And akhlaq and manners brings out a person's qualities in leadership. You know, they talk about leadership. They talk about those who lead. They talk about leaders. But if leaders, they don't have principles and akhlaq and manners and character, then they are going to fail. Even those who don't associate themselves with the principles that are man-made. For example, like to be decent, to be, self-controlling person, to give people their space, to talk when you talk the truth, to be able not to cut corners, to be able not to sugarcoat. Do you understand that? You guys know what sugarcoat means? You know what sugarcoat means? Do you know, Abdurrahman, what sugarcoat means? So, Ad, what is sugar coating? Obviously, very close. You're very close. I like that. Change something up. I like that. You're a step in the right direction. Yes, making everything sound good. Not only that, but making something other than what they actually are. For example, right? For example, like somebody did something wrong and I saw it. In Islam, we are taught to do three things. One of three things, right? To stop that person using force, right? If they're doing something and committing, like they're doing aggression and volume and transgression on someone, we could stop those people, right? By our force. Like, for example, somebody's beating another person. As a Muslim, you're supposed to stop that, right? And that's one, right? And two, talking them over, like calming down the person who is aggressive, right? That's something that you could do. And if you're not able to do that, be quiet and don't get involved yourself. And that's called the least of options, right? Sama, that's a manner. So you saw the person do something wrong. They did like really something egregious. You saw it. It was your eyes who saw it, right? But when somebody comes to you and they like, okay, he did something wrong and you knew it. And then you're like, oh, I didn't see it. That's sugarcoating. Because basically what you're telling is I'm dishonest. That's the signal you give. Give off, I should say, right? You're dishonest. So dishonesty is not something that you want to associate yourself with. But rather, honesty is what you associate yourself. Okay, so we're going to stop right here for this introduction, inshallah ta'ala. I expect everyone, inshallah ta'ala, to be attentive. I want everybody, inshallah ta'ala. I have your names right here. You need to bring a notebook. And this book. If you don't have this book right now, if you don't have this book, the Ma'alan is going to give you this kind of book. The books that just came in, I think they divided the book into two. Those of you who had this book, bring your book. So it's not going to cost you anything to bring your old book. It's the same thing, right? Those of you who don't have the book, you're going to have the book. But listen, guys, you need to be serious. This class is going to be really, really serious. It's going to be at the end, there's going to be a competition between us, this masjid, and just like before, that other masjid. It's a combined, it's a collaborative effort, right? And we're collaborating with Masjid al-Taqwa, and we want you to succeed, okay? So Su'ad, thank you for joining. You're gonna be joining back at 6:05, or actually 6 o'clock, after we pray Maghrib for the next class. I sent you the link, so I don't know if you have the next link, inshallah ta'ala. And we're going to stop right here. Like I said, we're expecting other teacher to take over this class by next Friday. If he doesn't, he didn't give us yes yet. But if he doesn't, I'm going to continue this class, inshallah ta'ala. Jazakumullah khairan. And those of you, you could go over there. We pray, inshallah ta'ala. Su'ad, so nice to see you again. I'll see you in about 20 minutes, okay? The other teacher, I think, is going to have like 30 minutes to teach today. And then, inshallah ta'ala, we have tomorrow to come back. Barakallahu fikum.